I Allt för Sverige får vi följa 10 svensk-amerikaner som har återvänt till Sverige för att finna sitt ursprung. En efter en slås de ut tills bara vinnaren återstår. Priset är en återförening med sin svenska släkt. Årets Sverigeresa har bjudit våra amerikaner på både svenskt vardagsliv.
The temperature, what do you think?
Probably cold.
Cold?
Och turnéliv.
Vi ska ta en pissepaus. Yeah.
Very strange, just off the side of the road. Like it was just natural.
Det har varit en omtumlande resa.
This is like reading about my dad. I get it now.
It feels like I'm home.
Och förra veckan blev Mike den fjärde deltagaren att lämna Allt för Sverige.
I never want to bring sad tears to anybody's eyes. If you want to cry, be happy tears, okay?
Denna vecka fortsätter resan i Dalarna.
I can't believe I'm here, honestly. I feel so relieved after that last elimination.
I waited too long. It's okay, baby. Good job.
We love Mike. He is definitely gonna be missed in the group. You're okay.
I'm so sorry.
Going home, that threat was tough. Being at a place where I knew I hadn't had my day and I was playing for the ability to be here and pull through that, I mean, it was tough. That I won't sugarcoat it anyway. But the payoff, you know, is amazing being here.
Oh my God, look at that big horse.
I know.
I didn't know it was in front of me.
It looks like
hey,
it.
Hey, forget the horse.
What?
There's a car.
Hey. Oh, look at it. All right, guys, it's my turn. I think everyone else opened one. I'm opening this
probably.
One. Probably. Yeah, okay, here we go.
All right.
Oh
my gosh.
Okay, here's the letter. Dear Americans, welcome to the heartland of Sweden, Dalarna, and to the city of Mora. Matt, to you, it's more like welcome home. Can you feel the spirit of your forefathers? Because this is where they came from.
I hate the cheesiness of people being like, it just feels right, it feels good. But I am the calmest I've been in 3 weeks of this adventure. And I feel like finally I'm where I should be in this entire thing.
The American coffer contains, oh gosh, blah, 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 soup, blah, blah. It's basically blueberry soup.
Okay.
Most people who visit Dalarna drinks this during their visit. Dalkrans branch from a birch if you come across a sauna. And the family treasure chest of Matt.
Yay! You have been lucky!
I would have to say that the coffer today with my treasure and the letter was the highlight so far of all of this. This is what I've been here and waiting for.
Dalarna is the most famous for the Dala horse, dalahäst. You will visit the Dala horse factory.
Awesome. No way.
Where you make your very own horse. Yay.
Hey.
How about that?
That's awesome.
I think a Dala horse means to me what it means to everybody. Sweden. You know, I think pretty much every Swedish-American has a Dala horse in their house, and you know, they probably try and educate their friends on it if they don't know about it.
Our own horse.
From the time I was born, we always had Dala horses around the house. They've just been kind of loved by our family for generation after generation. So I'm very excited to be able to not only buy my own Dala horses, but to make my own Dala horse. It's crazy.
Look at all these horses.
Wow.
There's like a million of them.
You know, I didn't even know what the Swedish flag looked like before I got here, which is kind of embarrassing, but I knew it was blue and yellow. But you know, what we see in America is, for Sweden is the Dala horse.
Swedish colors.
They're
they're all hand
crafted
and hand painted.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What do you guys think of this one?
I like that.
I think Mora is an adorable little town. It's a little commercial, but that's okay. I like commercial.
Don't laugh at me.
Swedish birds.
Good thing I bought a suitcase, huh?
I think it's really neat to be in the heartland of Sweden. Just be able to take part in something that is so Swedish.
Great.
We're at the Zornmuseet.
All right, this tells us about his life a little bit, I guess.
Well, he's got a good mustache. You know, it takes a little time to grow them out proper.
The Zorn Museum was a pleasant surprise for me. Just being able to see how this master really worked and his inspiration.
Ooh, this one's really pretty. Wow. What do you think of that, John?
That's very humbling.
No wonder he was one of Sweden's best artists, right? Brilliant. What do you think, John?
I think it's pretty humbling, is what it is. I mean, the polka scene is nice, but I prefer his solitary figures.
So which one's your favorite?
Definitely the Valkula there.
Right there.
I agree. When I walked in this room, I was immediately drawn to that painting. And it's just very serene.
It's a wonderful piece.
Art really isn't my thing. You know, maybe Dawn, who's more artistic, or even John, who surprised me, I think they probably get more out of the paintings, but I was pleasantly surprised at how much I enjoyed it.
He took 5 trips to America.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. His last one in 1911. Oh, my gosh. What? He was at the World's Fair in Chicago in 1893.
Looks like he really loved America. Hmm? I'm very excited about this start. It's all about art, which I'm 100% about, you know. Going to the Zorn Museum, getting to paint Dala horses. What's next, you know? This is fantastic, I'm loving it.
Oh my gosh!
It goes on and on and on.
Isn't that weird?
What the hell?
It's like a little village.
It is like a little village.
I can't believe how many of these buildings there are.
Mora probably means, at this point, pretty much everything. This is the history of the Anderson family as I know it, and I would love to find out everything I can about this area and why they left here and what took them to the United States and all those things.
I know we joke around a lot and stuff, yeah. But I've never really sat down and talked to you about, now I see you're from this beautiful area, but I haven't talked to you about
why you're here.
Yeah, why you're here. What was your story? Sure. I've never heard it.
Why I'm here has changed. Mm-hmm. I was talking to my parents about it. And my dad, it's my dad's side of the family, who is Swedish. And the excitement in my dad, as he's gotten older, genealogy has become very important to him. Mm-hmm. This change that I saw in my dad when I said, here's this experience. Here's what I could do. It was like this 75-year-old guy was like a 9-year-old again. And he's like, and what are you gonna do? And where do you guys go? And how do you know? And just this excitement that I've never seen on Mel Anderson's face before. I was raised in a Mormon family, and I'm a gay guy. And when I came out to my parents, my biggest fear was my dad. And the night that I talked to my folks, my dad was very silent, like he always is. And he kind of put his head down, and he put his head up, and he said, you know, Matt, you're our son. We'll always love you. And I guess that's why this is important, because that's a gift he gave me that he didn't have to buy. He couldn't order anywhere. And it's silly that it took me to sitting in this little village to realize that maybe that's why this is so important, that I have this chance to return that favor in a way. He's just been that good man. And I want to know where that comes from, because I want to appreciate it more, and I want to thank, however I can, what he gave me. You know, whatever I can take home, whatever stories, whatever I can glean from this experience, just to find out
you know, where does he get his humor? Where does he get his music? Why is he the good man that he is? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't think it just came from Rupert, Idaho, you know?
Yeah.
Why is he has a really great sense of humor. Mm-hmm. Really great sense of humor. Where'd that come from? You know, I'm here for this experience, but ultimately I'm here for Mel Anderson and just, you know, get as much as I can for him because this is the greatest thing I can give him.
Här i Mora slutar Gustav Vasas äventyr i Dalarna och flykten undan danskjävlarna. Från Onässtugan fick han fly genom utedasset. I Marnes sticker de spjut genom hölasset där han gömt sig och blod droppar ner i den vita snön. Men kusken skär ett jack i hästens ben och skyller blodet på det. I Isala får han en dask i rumpan av bondmoran och danskarna tror han är en simpel bonddräng. Han går genom isen, han göms i källare, han mördar en fogde. Om nu allt är sant. I Gustav Vasas egen version är det förrädiska dalkarlar han flyr ifrån. Historien om Hölasset är en vandringssägen som berättas om andra hjältar i andra länder. Och i den äldsta källan om flykten till Norge är det snöskor han pulsar på till Sälen. Så det kanske inte är historiskt riktigt, men det är riktigt bra historier. Så vi kör på i fädernas spår.
So here are our teams, guys. You ready for this?
Ready.
Team challenge, team yellow. Dawn, Rebecca, Lori.
Uh-oh.
Red team.
Girl against boys.
Shane, John, and Matt. Boys against girls.
Girls against boys.
So I guess you guys go ahead and grab your shirts.
Small.
Large.
Boys against girls to me is fine. I mean, I don't look at the boys and think they're any smarter or more able to do things than the girls.
Okay, girls, so this is the deal, that I cannot go through another elimination, at least not right now.
I agree.
I mean, I can't.
Okay.
We're gonna take this to girls and we're gonna wipe their faces on the pavement. You got it?
Yeah.
The bloodbath.
Yeah.
This is ours.
Wow.
All right, let's go.
Hello again.
Hello.
Hey, Anders.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Today, the challenge is on legendary ground. You might very well say that the history of Sweden as a consolidated nation starts with a young, rebellious Gustav Vasa and his adventures here in Dalarna. It's 1520. The Danes rule Sweden. They've just beheaded 82 noblemen in the Stockholm bloodbath, among them Gustav Vasa's father. This part of the country is known for being rebellious, so this is where Gustav Vasa runs to start an uprising. At first, people here are reluctant, and he's already headed for Norway through the snow when he changes their mind and set after him. The rest is history. The legendary chase to catch Gustav Vasa is celebrated every year with a 90-kilometer ski race and in today's team challenge. Good luck.
Thank you.
Lagen ska genomföra ett Vasalopp med två stationer. Första stationen är att kasta varsin krans runt en dalkulla. Den andra är att med hjälp av blåbärssoppa lösa ett matematiskt problem. Skidorna har plats för hela laget så det gäller att alla drar åt samma håll på vägen mot den klassiska målgången. Deltagarna i det förlorande laget måste senare mötas i en utslagstävling.
Starting off the skis, we've got to be very coordinated, which as women. Although, you know, the boys are smart, but I feel like the women are great at concentrating the moving on. Whereas maybe, hopefully, the boys might get a little flustered and just think about points and just try to rush through it.
So it's just like that storybook, that turtle one.
Mm-hmm. The tortoise and the hare.
Yes. It's slow and steady wins the race.
I think what we need to do is this. We need to get our rhythm down, left, right, sure. Left, right.
And say it out loud.
Say it out loud, of course, so we get it down.
Physical, we got this. And then when we get to the math problem, that's where we're gonna have a little bit of a problem. I've flunked algebra in high school twice, and I flunked it 3 times in college.
So, are you ready?
Ready.
Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the tracks, our forefathers for future victories. Klara, färdiga, go!
Left,
Go, 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 go. Okay, ready?
Slide. John?
Let me know when you're in.
John, I'm in. Whoops.
Go.
I'm in.
In.
Go.
Keep your feet back. Nope, a little more, a little harder.
A little higher.
Okay, almost.
Good job. Shit.
Yes.
Come on, you got it.
You're doing fine.
Throw it like a frisbee. Throw it like a frisbee.
Good.
Perfect.
Yeah, Lori.
There you go.
Read the letter.
This is a mathematical problem with a mathematical solution.
Before you are three containers. Using the two smaller containers, you are to pour exactly 1 deciliter of blueberry juice into a glass provided by Anders.
The smaller container holds 5 deciliters and 3 deciliters respectively, 5, 3. You may pour back and forth between the three containers in order to reach your answer.
There is a precise mathematical solution for this problem. You should be able to pour exactly 1 deciliter of juice into Anders' glass.
When you believe you have solved the problem, call for Anders. He will measure your answer after you've poured your 1 deciliter of juice into his glass. Good luck.
So we just need to make sure we have 1 deciliter for Anders' glass. Is that correct? Is that what you are reading?
Yeah, we need to use the 2 containers. So. Let's start here.
So we need 3 deciliters, 1.
So this is their stop, okay?
The smaller container holds 5 deciliters.
Okay.
No, five.
The smaller two, five and 3.
So the smaller holds 5.
Smaller containers hold 5 and 3 respectively.
Okay, so 5 and 3.
Okay.
Okay, so if we pour 2 cups into this, this will hold 5. This leaves 1 here because 3 plus 3 is 6. Let's go.
I think it went well, a couple hiccups there and there. I think altogether, I think our biggest fear was the math problem. Shane, the very first thing he said is like, I'm not mathematic. And he busted that thing out. When I knelt down to look at the table, I was like, man, I'm thirsty. And then I was like, oh, we're doing a math problem. So I'm glad he was there. It was great, it was good.
Stop.
I don't know where that came from. I just was looking at those numbers, 3 and 3 is 6, -1, boom, put it in there, and it just came to me.
Is that 1 deciliter?
It's perfect.
Yes! Let's go, guys. Side, left, right, 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 left, right. Woo! Good job. Now we just gotta wait.
All right.
Okay, we did take a little long on that thing, but I think we're okay.
Stop. Okay?
I feel like it wasn't good enough.
If that's 3, and this is 5.
Stupid math. I had no clue. I had no clue, and I knew I couldn't. I would have been more of a problem if I opened my mouth.
That's fine.
Go. Okay.
Awesome. I cannot go through another elimination. I just can't. So I just want to keep going.
Stop.
And I don't know if I have even the confidence. I don't know if I have the confidence left to even do it.
Thank you, guys.
What a day. What a race. The sign says, in the tracks of our fathers for future victory, I mean, here we are. I'm in Mora. This is the tracks of my father's right here, started here, and this is huge. This is great.
Over 2 minutes.
I think we probably had a couple advantages.
Well, I think what hurt, I knew those stupid rings, too. I mean, they're so, I'm not going to make an excuse, but they're so tall, or, you know.
Yeah. Here's what I think. It's our last day or two that we know we're all going to be together. We can either be really sulky about it, or we can agree that we're going to have a good time and enjoy what we have left. Because one of the three of us are going home. There's no doubt about that. So rather than sulking and making it a lousy experience, let's try to have a little bit of fun and see the town.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Good job, ladies. Even though we lost, we all worked well together, and I'm proud of you.
Wait, mine got all twisted.
You know, reflecting on today, it's a reminder about how bittersweet this competition is, actually.
What?
Dude. So you know what? I got to tell you something. You know, we're having fun and games here, fishing, but one of them girls is going home.
That's right.
Yeah. I mean, we have short time left here, and it's going to be getting tougher. It's tougher for all of us because as the time goes on, you know, we're becoming closer friends. It's a cold equation is what it is, you know? Your friends have to go home for you to get to the end.
And I caught a fish. Huff!
You did not.
I did too. It just let go. Every second in Sweden matters. I don't take any of it for granted, you know? I don't spend it worrying about I didn't sleep good or anything. I spend it about how can I soak up this positive energy here, you know? And every minute is just so precious to me.
Where's John?
He's in the water.
Is it cold?
Oh, it's cold.
I'm proud of you, John. You're scaring all my fish away, John.
I'm super excited to visit the Dala Horse Factory. When we read that in the letter, I was just like, that's all I could think about this whole time we've been here. It's like, we get to go paint Dala horses. So I'm excited to see how they're made and see how the locals do it. Do they use modern tools? You know, I have no clue what we are about to experience.
So this is the first step before the Dala horse is born.
Something one of you want to try? Okay. Voluntary?
Sorry. I'm here. I better.
So, go ahead.
All right. I'm nervous. Here we go. All right.
You can do it. Think of cookie cutter.
Just kidding. I know. I like cookies. That was a good way to put it.
Dala horse for me has always represented Sweden. When my parents came to Sweden about 6-7 years ago, they brought us all one home. And, you know, for me, it was just something to set on the shelf and say, all right, it's part of my heritage. I'm Swedish-American. This is great. But, you know, the chance to be here and actually see it makes it a lot more real.
So, perfect.
Thank you. That was good. Yeah. Are you guys hiring?
Yes.
Oh, perfect. This is good. I feel good.
I was so impressed by the factory. I thought that it would be more produced. And still, it's fascinating how much work goes into it and how much hands-on it is.
Is this your only carver?
No,
I'm just kidding.
We have 50 carvers.
This is my people, Mora, this is Dalarna. This is us. We're crafters. We're crafty little people.
The best carver may carve the horses for 5 minutes.
Four or five minutes. Oh,
yeah.
My gosh.
And you take four or five days?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It wouldn't be a 4 or 5 minute process. A lot of people don't get to do this. They get to come see the Dala horses and buy them, but we get to make them. It just takes it to a whole new level that we're getting to experience, you know, what few people get to do.
Right? Perfect.
Now, will you be able to identify the fact that Rebecca dipped those horses?
That would be a bit difficult. I think we need to mark them somehow.
I loved watching them carve the horses, but I have to admit my favorite part was probably painting the horses. It was just so much fun.
I think this is an acquired talent. How come they don't have tails?
They do.
Tails?
They do have
they
tails.
Have, look there.
Oh, okay, they're painted on.
I don't think I'm doing very good.
I didn't either. The first thing I did was mess up my brush.
I think I'm a little rusty on my painting skills of the Dala horse.
I can tell you I have working here for 30 years, but I'm in the primary. And I learned to paint 81.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sitting at home after work and okay. sitting and painting.
So I was sitting there, I'm thinking, I can't believe I'm here. You know, you see these things all around the country, and I'm actually at the factory. People that have lived here their whole lives haven't had that opportunity.
Here's my horse.
Oh, it looks good.
You're a bad liar.
Oh, it does.
You guys are here for all a bunch of big liars.
This is it. This is my Dala horse. I don't think I'll be being asked over to Sweden to paint Dala horses anytime soon.
I think it's not bad for my first go around, you know?
And then mine's just a little bit of a hot mess, you know?
Yes.
Kind of like you.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's not about the beauty on the outside, but the beauty on the inside and the memories that are that it will bring back.
I don't want you guys to be jealous, but it's really good.
Hey, that is good.
I think being somewhere and doing things that are specific to an area, especially this area for me, just makes it all more real that this is an experience of going somewhere and relating to something that I have history in. And it just makes a connection to me to the past that I will cherish forever.
Hello.
Hi, Anders.
Hi.
Welcome. So today I'm thinking we should talk a bit about Swedish folk music. The late 1800s was a time of big changes. Industrialism, the labor movement, and religious revivalism. In the eyes of these new awakened believers, folk music was the sound of evil. It connected to old superstitious beliefs that musicians possessed magic skills and had an alliance with the devil.
It seems to me that that throughout the ages, religion has, you know, tried to control people and tell them what to do. So I guess it wasn't any different over here than it was anywhere else in the world.
Playing folk music was a sign of bad habits, sinful living, and drinking. Playing the fiddle was sinful.
Swedish people, like, haven't always been really nice. Kind of like when Christianity took over, they thought anything that had to do with the Greek, anything, was from the devil. Kind of like the same thing with Swedish folk music.
When Anders returned to Mora after years abroad, he was shocked to discover that the old traditions, culture, clothes, music were dying. So he initiated a folk music gathering. The following years, similar folk music festivals appeared all over Sweden. The fiddlers started playing again, and they still do. This is what it sounds like.
What? Oh my God!
This is awesome!
To see those people walking around that corner, which I thought was just like this recording of music, it blew me out of the water. And then they walked around and I was like, oh my God! And you could just feel like this atmosphere change. It was just amazing.
I don't know why it hit me so emotionally. I've always been one where music affects me, but to hear those violins and to hear the passion and all of these people in their Swedish traditional costumes, it was just, it's just magical.
Yay!
Okay. Now we're going to have some traditional Swedish allsång. I actually have a lot of experience in that field. Sing along.
All right.
Yeah. What can go wrong? A lot, I think. Okay, are you ready? Rönnedalans skuttar med ett skratt ur sin säng.
This stop has been incredible. This Swedish folk music that we've never heard and suddenly we're all big fans of. And I loved the faces of the people playing. They were very happy to be playing it, and that's what music should be.
Och se så många blommor som är redan slagit upp på ängen. Då vi var man då blomkatt för att blomma.
Just sitting here today, where I feel like this is it. This is where, this is my history, you know? It's awesome to have the stories here and now the chance to finally get them. I think first and foremost, I am an adventurer. I think I'm a friend, a pretty loyal friend. And I think that I'm fun. I like life. And I know that's cheesy, everyone says that, but I think that I really do.
Ah, Sisyphus, how are you?
Ah, I feel pretty good, Mr. Hayden.
I live here in Washington, D.C. I am a full-time professional actor, doing musicals and plays around Washington.
Watching tourists, reading maps.
Watching doormen taking naps.
Is that mine? Watching doormen taking naps?
I grew up way out west in Boise, Idaho. Wheels go round and round my mind. I was raised in a big Mormon family. In Mormonism, we don't drink, we don't smoke, no premarital sex. It is a faith that is focused on a lot on family. Growing up Mormon and realizing that I was a little bit different in the sense that I am gay, I think the biggest thing about it was the loneliness, not really knowing how I fit in.
You ever been to Sweden?
I've not been to any other.
Do you want to get in my bags and go with me?
No.
I've grown a little bit apart from the church for no more reason than I need to figure out myself and my relationship with this God or this Heavenly Father, that how I fit into it all. You ready for this?
We're about as ready as we can be. Are you ready for this?
Yeah. What if I find a dark secret?
Even better.
Yeah, that'd be exciting too.
I think that positive traits aren't just dreamed up. Sons learn things from fathers that in turn learn things from their fathers. And I think that, you know, the goodness of my dad had to come from somewhere. I have no expectations. I come into this completely an open book. I know names. I know dates, and it's a very limited number of names and dates that I know. I don't know what I'll find out, and I expect nothing. I will welcome anything. Dear Matthew, not very many people emigrated from the town of Mora, your family's home for generations. There were compelling reasons to believe that your ancestors had no choice but to leave for the hope of an unknown place. The story of these Anderson ancestors takes a decidedly more personal turn toward you, Matthew, in the life of Olaf Ole Anderson. He spent most of his childhood here on a farm in Mora, the place that had cradled and nourished his forefathers for generations. Olaf Ole's parents were Hansen's Hans Anderson and mother Anna Hans' daughter. Hans and Anna had seven children altogether. They were a simple family who lived in spare conditions. I cannot believe I'm standing in front of this house where my great-grandpa Ole grew up. This is a little overwhelming, more than I thought it, yeah, more than I thought it would be. I love it. I cannot believe that this room and this room had seven kids. The two of them and then seven children. Mercy. It feels incredible to be here. This is where it all happened. This is where it's their life right here. From what we know, Hans was essentially forced to leave Dalarna because of one decisive detail in your family's history that set Olaf Oli's childhood at the family farm apart from the social norms of this time. It was stated that Olaf Oli's family were Mormons.
Your relatives demonstrated great courage in standing firm on their religious beliefs during a time when it was virtually illegal to practice religion outside the authorized confines of the Lutheran Church. Excuse me. I can't imagine how difficult it had to have been. They were a family that stood for what they believed in. And I see this faith and this courage these people had in my dad. That's what's passed down.
Olaf Oli was only 11 years old when his parents courageously decided to leave Sweden for the chance of a new life in America.
It's amazing. It's really quite amazing.
They had to leave. It wasn't farming. It wasn't starvation. It was a faith that is everything my family is. Your family members established fine lives for themselves in America. Olaf Oli grew up and married Margaret Miller. Their son, Elmer William, was destined to become, in time, your father's father.
In the language by which Olaf Oli had lived his formative early years, Elmer William was your farfar. These are people that I came from. 7 years ago, I was someone that very much like a great-great-grandfather stood up and said, I need to make a change. And so I went to my family and I said, here's who I am. And that was scary. To me, that was my leaving Mora, really. And that opened up a whole new world for me. A whole new land, like a great-great-grandfather who needed somewhere new to practice what he so firmly believed.
Pretty awesome out here, guys.
Sauna!
This is pretty amazing out here. It's the hills, lakes, trees. It's beautiful, you know? And this is really what I pictured Sweden to look like. So stereotypically, this is Sweden to me, yeah. Incredible.
Ready?
Go on. I'm just taking a shower in the birch.
I would step back a little bit.
How much should I put on?
Maybe one more. There we go. Actually, do two more.
Two more?
Yeah, two
more. It's not
going to
last very long.
Hurry up.
Hurry up.
Come on.
Hurry up. Close the door.
Oh, my God.
You'll get used to
breathing here.
Oh.
I can't even breathe. This has to be 115 degrees hotter than it is in Florida.
I can't be in here very long, otherwise I'll turn invisible.
Yeah.
I've actually only peeked my head into a sauna. I've never sat in one before. It was pretty humid. I grew up in Arizona. It was 120 degrees, like every day in the summer, just not humid. So it was like a big blanket.
Oh my God. If I drop, just throw me in the water. I should wake up.
You're not gonna drop. We're talking about a little more water on the stove. There we go.
But I hate to tell you, but
are you seriously done?
We'll see ya. This area is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. You know, between the birches and, you know, the view from sitting in the sauna, you sit up on that upper bench and look out onto the lake. It was fascinating. You know, this is God's country.
Seriously, the
this is the coldest water I've seen in weeks.
All right, back in the sauna.
It's so cold.
This is
some kind of sausage.
It smells delicious.
Is it?
It's not bad. I think it's elk / moose.
That's good stuff.
Mm-hmm. It's like venison almost. It's good.
It's very good.
This is so pretty. Does it remind you of Northern Michigan at all?
Absolutely, it does.
What is that kind of
sausage.
Meat? But what?
We don't know.
They were delicious.
You know what? It might even be the ears. Hello, hello?
Can I try it? Yeah, I might as well.
I'm totally a sausage girl. I mean, in Wisconsin, that's what we would eat. Cheese, crackers, sausage. And I knew when I bit into it, I'm like, this isn't the right texture I'm used to. So the worst I thought it was gonna be elk. And I'm like, you know what? Whatever, I'm in Sweden, I'll just eat it.
God help me.
Hey.
Hey.
Ola heter jag. Det här är mitt ställe.
Is this yours?
Ja, yes.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Jag ser att ni äter...
The sausage?
Have some.
Oh, yeah.
It's very good.
What is this?
Gustavskorv.
Gustav's the name, and korv is sausage.
Oh. But
okay. Gustav's det är speciellt. Det här är hästkorv. Det är gjort på hästar.
Hästar.
He was trying to say what it was, and I wasn't quite getting it. I'm like, oh, he's trying to tell me it's elk.
When he was saying, like, hesk something, I'm like, hesk, hesk, hesk. I think I know that word.
Moses.
Wow! Very good.
Oh, yeah!
Very good.
Yeah, good.
No!
Example,
I didn't
like it.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, my God!
She's gonna...
Right?
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Very good. Very good.
No!
At least you recognize it.
Just don't barf on your bed.
I knew something was wrong, Shane!
I have to vomit.
No, you don't.
I have to!
It's just, the blood just drained from my body.
What's happening in my world? Horse, crow, reindeer, moose.
In there?
Oh, Gustav's korv? That was excellent. Very good, very good. You know, a horse is nothing but a different shaped cow. Now, do you use the whole horse?
No!
Where is he when I need him most?
God. He's laughing at us.
Still have some left.
It is what
here.
It is.
Sauna. Jump in the lake.
Don't forget about the horse meat.
That's right, some Gustav's korv, and this wonderful picnic now.
This is a pretty amazing place.
Yeah.
Almost as nice as Värmland.
Which is almost as nice as Småland.
Nothing compares to Stockholm.
Except for Motala.
Spoken like a true Stockholm person.
I know.
I can really see why with each of our ancestors, they went to places where it was familiar. Mm-hmm. The towns they came from reminded me of towns they went to.
Mm-hmm. That's very true. When one of us wins, we're going to meet our family. What are you guys going to tell your family if you get to meet them?
If I get to see my family, I would probably say, I've heard so much about them and that we've never forgotten about them, even though it's
aww,
been...
Aw, that's sweet.
We know they're there and we think of them often.
That's very true. If I meet my family, I brought a lot of photographs. I want them to see what kind of family they have. I'm not just meeting my family. I'm the door for them to meet their family in the United States as well.
That's nice. I never even thought of that.
I am kind of worried to meet my family a little bit because of my situation. So it's a little scary for me. I don't know if they'll accept me for who I am. I don't know how Swedes feel about gay people. Being gay in a small Nebraska town, I just knew it wasn't going to work and that I was going to have to leave my friends and family if I wanted to prosper. And so I did that, you know, and then I met this guy and fell in love with him. And the first time I ever had sex, I contracted HIV. I don't know how Swedes feel about HIV-positive people. It's kind of scary, you know? Is that going to scare them? Are they going to... Do they know that they can hug me and not get HIV? Because there's people out there that don't know that, so... I used to be this really happy-go-lucky person, and then a lot of shit happened in my life. But this trip has really brought that peace back to me, and I feel like I can be like this really happy-go-lucky person again. And so it's life-saving. It's not life-changing. This trip has really been life-saving. I think that it won't be a problem, but if it is, you know, I'll just deal with it and...
I think you're gonna be fine.
I hope so.
You will be.
Thank you. But I will not eat whipped cream and strawberries in front of them because this isn't going so well.
Why should I use it a fork?
This could be my last night. Can you imagine? Seems like it's my home now. I wish I could sit here and tell you that I'm so excited to be so close to getting that chance, but I don't feel that, especially with an elimination tomorrow. I'm not gonna say I've given up. I'm one to always expect the worst and hope for the best.
Yes, we may be gone for several, you know, 120
odd years. That's what I'm saying. It's been over 100 years and we still think about these people.
Yeah, I'm still looking for them.
Yeah. That says a lot about us in the power of family, because it has. It's been like 150 years.
En anledning till att Dalarnas alla kulturyttringar har fått sån jäkla spridning sägs vara att jordbruket där var så knapert att folk var tvungna att vara allkonstnärer och ge sig ut på långa arbetsvandringar. Dalmålare spred blommande kurbitsar i Stockholm, tog kullorna över som roddarmadammer. I Vomhus och Bonäs gjorde smycken av hår som kvinnorna sen sålde även långt utanför landets gränser. Men sen, till midsommar, då kom alla hem igen och så kom även midsommarfirandet här att bli alldeles speciellt. Och så är det dalahästen förstås. Känd från 1600-talet som en biprodukt till möbeltillverkningen så spred den sig med vandrande kullor och masar. Och i dagens utslagstävling är det också en slags dalahäst i huvudrollen. Isabelle heter hon. Riktig pudding.
It has been an incredible, amazing 3.5 weeks. No offense guys, I love you to pieces, but I really hope I'm saying goodbye to one of you and not everyone today, because I just don't want to go home. I was able to meet one of my cousins at the airport, and it was a wonderful way to start this experience.
I hope we'll see you again.
So I'll do everything I can to win.
Yes, yes.
To me, family is everything. You know, in order to see more of them, that we're going to have to win.
The way I work on things is I always think about the best possible outcome.
You look so much like my family in America.
Meeting my relative, it fueled me, you know, and just having that connection makes me feel like when I meet everyone at the end, that it's just going to be more family, and it's just going to, I'm going to feel more at home in Sweden, more than I already do.
I still have to see my relatives, the lady, I keep saying the same story at the airport. I said, don't worry, I'll win.
Thank you.
She really thought. She walked away saying, okay, you know, I'll see you when you win. I don't feel I can go home yet.
Let's get it done.
Okay.
I tävlingen gäller att på snabbast tid få hästen Isabelle runt en bana med 10 portar. För varje riven port läggs 20 straffsekunder på sluttiden. Amerikanerna har fått de svenska kommandorna höger och vänster för att lättare dirigera hästen. Deltagare med sämst sluttid måste lämna allt för Sverige.
Yesterday, I know I said I had no confidence, but when I saw what the competition was, my confidence just went through the roof. If it comes to animals, I can do this. I have this like connection with them. It's really weird. I'm like Dr. Doolittle.
Hopefully this is an intuition competition, just being able to connect with the animal. And in that calms me a little bit.
Last time I went horseback riding, it really got ruined when my husband's horse peed on my shoe. So I think I'm due for a good experience with a horse, and I'm hoping that Isabel is gonna be really nice to me.
Okay. Vänster.
Esther?
Esther, whoa, stop. Hey, Esther.
Höger. Vänster. 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 Höger. Vänster. Vänster.
Höger.
Höger. Höger. Höger. Höger. Höger. Höger. Vänster. 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 Vänster.
Vänster.
Vänster, 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 vänster. Höger, höger, höger. Bra, inte bra. Höger, höger, höger. Vänster, vänster, höger, höger.
Vänster.
I'm really nervous right now. I know I knocked over one tennis ball. I'm hoping I didn't knock over more. So we'll see when the results are read. Right now, I'm just a nervous wreck waiting for the results because I really don't want to go home.
It's okay. I'm not feeling that great about this competition. I'm just hoping somebody did worse than I did. I don't know what happened out there. She just wasn't listening. And I may have been holding too tight on the reins. We'll see. Faster. 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 Finish line, I was like, there you go. Is that enough? You know, I'm trying so hard to stay in this thing. And I don't know if it's enough. So then I just fell because all the emotions, I just fell. I don't feel like I want to go home right now. Okay, I'm good.
Okay, so are you ready for the result?
Guess so.
I mean...
One of you made it through the whole course without knocking down any balls, missing any gates.
Holy shit.
And with the best time.
Holy cow.
And that was Rebecca.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Come on.
The one who leaves Allt for Sverige today, knocked down three balls.
Oh my God, don't.
and had a total time of 2 minutes and 17 seconds. Dawn, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, don't do it.
I knew it was me.
I really wanted to spend some more time here. I really wanted to see my relatives and hug them. I'm going home. I'm going home. All my life, I've been torn about who I am. I've always known my Korean side. I've never known anything about my Swedish side. And just through all of the adventures here, I've felt more and more Swedish. And I've felt like the people of Sweden have really welcomed me into their hearts.
Can you tell us what you guys did?
It was driving a horse just like I drove a stick shift. Wow. I thought I had it at first, but horses are harder to drive than stick shift, guys.
Hey, Anders.
Hey, Anders.
So, it's time to say goodbye again. So.
Okay. I'll see you soon.
Yes, you will. Yeah.
Group hug. This adventure has been the greatest adventure of my life. The moment I stepped on the ground of Sweden, she had my heart. I felt peace, light, and beauty everywhere I went.
Oh my gosh.
It's right there behind me.
Will you come back?
Absolutely. I'm not done with Sweden.
No, that's not great. I'm glad you're here.
I'm writing a fairy tale. I want to come back. I want to learn Swedish.
Oh.
And go to Sweden school if I can.
Sounds great. You got a lot of roots and connections here. And here's your family tree.
Oh my God.
You can open it in a while. And also a box with all the research we found out about your Swedish family. So, you're not empty-handed. It was great having you here. Have a safe flight back home. Det var jättekul att ha det här.
Jättekul att ha det här.
Hej då.
Tack så mycket.
Det var så lite så.
Hej då.
Hej då.
I've learned so many things about myself. I've learned where I come from. That I'm stronger and more courageous than I ever thought. That Sweden feels like home.
Oh, it goes back so much further. Beautiful names.
There's so many things, beautiful, wonderful things here. Jag älskar Sverige.
We'll go by ferry to one of our favorite summer places, the island of Gotland.
I've never been to an island.
You haven't?
Never, ever.
Never, ever?
Ever, never.
I was kind of like dumbfounded to see streets, houses, not huts.
I think Disney came to Sweden and totally ripped off Sweden.
I learned everything about true love from them.
Oh my God.
He's naked.
Ew.
Oh my God.
He's totally naked.
If it would have happened in the States, it would have been arrested.